that's kind of a joke, it doesn't do much. And then the IRS is also pretty inept. Your social security number is getting mailed through the mail. It's also not hard for any intelligent person to find your stuff. It used to be difficult, but you think you put that on all bank account applications. When you go rent places, like any of those random secretaries could just go on a photocopying spree and decide they hate you any given day. So this is why I would suggest that, but it is a little bit annoying. All right, so yeah, I do have the resource slides for later, but anyone have any questions or stuff about like what you're planning on doing that I might be able to clarify for you or discuss? This isn't necessarily the nitty-gritty of how to actually run through the taxes, but I do suggest you go through it and just use Tax Act because it's really good and it would let you go through and figure things out. But sure.
Who makes Tax Act or like whose software is it?
It's just a bunch of
companies.
They're a bunch of companies.
Oh,
it's a company.
Sponsored by
the no, it's a company that goes and is like, hey, we'll do that. Actually, if you are at a specific point, you don't make a certain amount of money, you're eligible for free filing anyway. I think I've only ever spent $30 to get my taxes done online. But again, you should pay something if it's Uber Compliance. The cool thing, though, is they do go and they kind of compete with each other about how much they can find. So when you get really complex and you're like, I'm going to itemize my deductions, which means instead of just getting a standard couple $1,000 from the government, I think I can get more by proving that I bought a house and that I did this and that I have kids and stuff like that. So when that happens, it's actually kind of fun because they've gone through and they read the tax code and they find all the different stuff that relates to you, and then they've automated how to cite it and they've automated the forms you have to fill out. And then they go auto-populate things and bundle it up and mail it for you.
This is a professional? This is what you get a professional do, or is this Tax Act?
This is Tax Act.
Oh, we're
yeah.
Using that.
Yeah. So it's far better than going through and actually filling stuff out. I think the max I pay is, yeah, I added a third state, so they're like, that'll be $15. You're like, okay, all right, fine, you deserve that. But it does into auto-populates and stuff, which is good. Any other questions?
Sure. What does itemize actually mean?
Itemize means you're laying it out for the government. You're actually making like an itemized list. It's like, I got my house, it's that much. I got this,
okay.
I got that. As opposed to the standard deduction, which is people like you would probably get this much anyway. That's your guess. So I'm going to fill out like the 1040 EZ form and just say, yep, give me that. That sounds good. So I do that. I've done that a couple times. More recently, I've switched to itemized just because there's a couple other things that I've run for.
Cool.
But
that makes sense.
Yep.
Do you recommend Tax Act over like TurboTax? Like I've used TurboTax. I feel like it's a little bit more expensive, but it's always been like super smooth and like pretty.
I am sure it is negligible.
Okay.
It's probably not that big a difference. They kind of feel like you go to Lifehacker or any other review sites and they'll like fluctuate. For what we're doing as far as what your tax situation looks like now, it's not very complex. It's pretty well spelled out.
So do you think?
I was negating your shell corporation, the shell corporation that, I don't know, sells rugs in Persia, right? But no, if it's pretty easy, it won't make a difference. You might want to do it both ways if you do itemized deductions and maybe they come up with stuff, but I wouldn't know beyond that. That would be weird territory. So, sure.
So as a corporation, if you get like, so when we get a contract in, you say somebody that like is in like, say our contract's like Maryland or whatever, and they give us money in New York, how are taxes handled across like state boundaries for like payment and stuff like that?
So they are doing business with our New York entity. So it doesn't really matter where they are. They pay us to a New York address. So that's pretty much what it works. The fact that it's reasonably easy for us to just do one thing at the end is great. Some e-commerce sites and stuff have really weird things where like, yeah, you gotta pay taxes to where it's delivered. But those are audibles. So for us, we just declare, hey, we earned this much in New York from this group. In certain cases, if it's business to business, we don't even really have to do we don't even really have to declare that per se. The way the government deals with you having to like itemize things is if you're making like over $300,000 a year, which we should likely get eventually too. Then you have to start proving, hey, you gotta do like an actual like balance sheet and use Quicken loans to figure out where you got money from so it doesn't look like it's materializing. But from where we are, again, very small fish, it doesn't really matter.
Cool.
One thing I just noticed, the credit freeze is evidently dependent on your state, whether or not they charge you money.
Yes, some states have made it free. Other states, it's like 10 bucks. I don't think it's ever more than 30 to get it done, like, everywhere. They also, again, aren't in the business of making it easy because then everyone would do it. So they don't publicize it, and they don't make it very very user-friendly. So oftentimes, you'll be calling people, you'll be emailing things, but you really do have to send it, like, certified mail to get them to do it, which is why it is kind of a little bit of a task. But, yeah, I can suggest it. So, yes?
So I hope that all of us leave Rensselaer and get awesome jobs with six-figure salaries and stock options and bonuses. At that point, do we hire a guy, or do you think that, like, what is the demarcation line for when we can just hire a tax service to do your taxes for you?
You will always be able to do your taxes yourself. It is certainly figured out. You are absolutely intelligent to do it. It is not hard. It will just take a lot of time. So I would say if I pay myself this much, it's going to look like it's going to take that long. And then you have this certain unknown figure of, like, A, risk of having the IRS on my tail, times odds that I would screw something up, right? So if that's indeed the case, then yeah, having someone that actually has to fill out, yeah, I'm authorized to do this, yep, everything's good. That's great because you also have someone who's kind of in the boat with you. If stuff hits the fan, you call them and say, hey, what did you screw up? And they're like, oh yeah, I messed up XYZ. So a little bit, hey, save your time. A little bit, there's stuff I don't know. Which is kind of dangerous, and I hate stuff I don't know because I can't fix it. And then there's also the shelter that's added by having some CPA look over stuff for you.
So. Well, what's added once you, like, start making more money? I mean, you still have a house, a car. Like, so what's the point of having a professional do it? You can have TurboTax or tax act for you.
So a little bit of just security on my part. With TurboTax, you ask pretty quick, but you'll still be sitting down for a couple of days, like, to do it right. Maybe a day, if it's not like that. Like, for me, I'm expecting it'll take me 3 or 4 hours. But the alternative is, hey, here's what I did this year, and a box of receipts, and the guy does it. So the amount of time you will spend talking to the guy is, like, an hour or two, and then he'll bounce your questions, and he'll say X, Y, Z. And the other thing is, it's an intelligent person who can give you advice, which is really useful. So I fully expect that the amount of advice I would get would exceed the amount I would pay for a professional after some arbitrary amount of money I would be making, or complexity. So that's just a personal, like, preference. But I do, like, I kind of have that philosophy with a lot of different experts. It's like a real estate agent. Like, yeah, they have a certain amount of like, overhead commission that you're going to do. But I think in general, I'll make more money with them doing the commission, helping me sell the house, than vice versa, right? It's kind of similar to that. It's whether or not the expert is the standard deviation smarter than you to make their commission worthwhile. So at least that's where I kind of fall. Yeah. Anything else? I hope that wasn't too bad.
You didn't
die. That's pretty short, too.
Yeah, you can get stuck.
You got. I took some of your time.
But yeah, so cool stuff. All right. If you have any questions, feel free to email me. There's a bunch of other stuff at the bottom of the slide, the interesting article there is. And then, yeah, these are things you can have tax expenses for. And then, yeah, IRS.gov is your friend. It's pretty bad. They said, make sure that JavaScripting is turned on to use our calculator. I'm like, who says JavaScripting? But all right, that's the people you're dealing with. So. Yeah, and then I guess updates then this week if we have no other questions. No, sure. We'll bring Dan up just so we can look at him too. Hi, Dan.
Dan.
Say hi.
Hey, guys.
You have to turn on your camera.
You turn on the camera. His microphone doesn't work.
You're good.
The mute switch is missing.
Cool stuff. So this week, I had a very interesting presentation last night at Foundry by Gail. So the good news is we wrapped up that project, and she seems pretty enthusiastic about it.
We're about a black belt.
Yeah, there you go. All
right. Right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Can I recommend?
Yeah.
Are they done?
Yeah.
Almost.
Yeah. Who actually went to the career fair today? Okay. Career fair? That's your hand. Yeah, there you go.
It's very tiring.
we got Devin in town for a little bit. Shankar might have already left. I'm not sure where Shankar is. But, oh well. And then, we also brought on some people this week. We brought on Adam and then Ron. So, welcome. We're going to add, I got to add you to Slack a little bit later, but that'll figure it out. So, it's pretty cool, but we're looking forward to it. And then we got a bunch of other projects coming through. We got we're meeting with the Connect project both after this, and we have a call tomorrow. Fellowship stuff's going pretty well for us, right? We got to eventually figure that out.
Crap. We have stuff due tomorrow for that, and I haven't touched it at all.
Nope. We'll figure it out.
Something new.
Yeah, but everyone got the classes they need, I hope. Too late now. So.
Yeah.
Just laying out. I find it's very hard to do. I don't think I've ever laid out. Has anyone actually laid out something? I don't know. Like, I've never seen it happen. Yeah, not today. Have you laid out?
Laid out something this semester?
Yeah.
Already?
No. I added like independent studies, like about a little less than a month before the semester ends.
What?
So,
I thought that's independent studies, but I don't think I'm going to class. But yeah, no, I think I also extended the actual hours I planned. I didn't know it, I'll increase the hours, and I just shot the paper. And then, any updates from you guys? We had breakfast. We had breakfast with Matt. We had Ray, Kiana, Devin, and I, and James. When James is doing his inhaler stuff. So he's working on a thing. I think he made a channel for it, so you should go ask him about it. But it's pretty fun. Matt seems to be doing pretty well. But do you have something to say? I didn't know if you were raising that.
Do you have an update for us, Ron?
Where's
you?
Yeah. All right. Cool. I am trying to think of other stuff we have to do. How's Recycle going? You guys?
Yeah, so we had a third party developer on